Welcome into our inaugural episode this season of Go Statesmen TV. Have a great show for you tonight. We'll be meeting new Lady Statesmen head basketball coach David Midlick. We'll also be heading out to Daryl Foreman Classic with the Delta State golf team and catching up with football after our first two games this season. But first, we head out to the running trail and catching up with the Bodin sisters of Delta State Cross Country.
The Delta State Lady Statesmen Cross Country team's underway with their 2012 season, and today we look at two very special runners, twin sisters Katie and Emily Bowden, who have come from Biloxi, Mississippi, to join the Statesmen running squad.
Well, just knew about them through recruiting and, you know, seeing times, checking out races that they had been participating in, and Stacy Hagenson, actually, that runs for me, and that's a junior, ran against them in high school and gave me some information on them. Very competitive, tough runners. Definitely ones for me to keep my eye on, and did. And, you know, we got them to come on a recruiting visit, and really thought this may be too far since they're, you know, down on the coast, but they actually committed on their visit here. So very excited about getting them, and looking forward to them running for us this year.
Running has always been part of the Bowden family, as the girls have started running since an early age.
My dad has always been an active member in the Gulf Coast Running Club. It's a local club. We participate on the coast, so before we were even born, he was a part of it, so it was natural to kind of grow up and have something to do with him and go out to run with him.
We'd go as a family and run the races together. And then in elementary school with the President's Fitness Test, we ran the mile, and that got the attention of the local high school coach, so he recruited us from there.
And did you play any other sports growing up, or was it mainly just running?
We were pretty big in soccer for a while. So after soccer for about 10 years, we decided to drop that and mainly focus on cross country.
And what was that decision to drop soccer and mainly focus on cross country? What was the big draw for you two to keep going cross country?
Well, we were better in cross country. We shined more in cross country. And we saw more of an opportunity for the future in cross country to continue on to college. Yeah.
There you go. Just talking about growing up as twins and kind of hanging everywhere together. Talk about how that's been growing up and how you can be competitive with each other.
Oh, yes. That's probably why we're into so many sports, is we just like to compete in friendly competition, but it's always natural to see who's better at what and just to compete with each other.
Yeah,
so
push each other, make each other better.
Well, I guess I'll have to ask the question. Is there a better runner between you two, or is it neck and neck?
Pretty neck and neck. It flip flops. Yeah. Like some seasons I'm better.
Yeah, I think Katie. we're together most of the way, but you know,
we flip flop. We go back and forth. So.
Yeah, I was talking to Coach Pickett a little bit ago. He was saying Stacy Hagen's around there for his attention. Pick up here with her. Some of your faces running, and also what drew you to want to come to Delta State.
Well, it was good to see Stacy again. We did run with her in high school, and she was always the girl to beat at the meet, so it's nice to be on the same team and be able to feed off of each other and benefit one team instead of rival as two. And I guess we heard Stacy came up here. My coach is talking about how they're building the program up, and it would be a great opportunity to join.
Yeah,
so we came on our campus visit, and it's a good fit.
It was really nice. I think the campus visit really drew us in. We got to know the girls, and they were really welcoming, and the coach was so. It was, we knew as soon as we stayed the first night, it was where we wanted to be, so.
And was there any doubt that you two would be going to the same college?
No.
No, we knew. Yes. We knew we were going to be at the same place. And my mom made sure of that, too.
Yeah.
She wanted us together, and we wanted to stay together, of course, so.
And you got a little bit far away from Biloxi, but still kind of close as well.
Yeah.
Your parents tried to come to any meets? Are they going to try to see
We're going this weekend. We're going to Mobile, and it's about an hour from our house, so they'll see us at that meet.
Yeah. And having your sister around here in college, how does that make things easier? How does it make it more fun for you guys to be around family when here at Delta State?
Yeah, it helps a lot because you're always with somebody. You're never alone, so it's you don't have that anxiety of not knowing somebody. It helps a lot.
Yeah, we help to prepare each other, too, before workouts. So we'll remind each other to drink and prepare all day and get good sleep. So there's always that reassuring person to get you on track and keep you on track. So.
And how did it feel in your guys' first collegiate race to help the team bring home a championship? I know you guys placed fourth and fifth. How did it feel to get out in that first race and have
it? It felt great. It was a great start to the season. It was just helps inspire you to be better, to see what else we can accomplish together. So it was a very good start to the season.
We're glad we could help the team out.
Yeah. So.
And what are your two goals for your freshman season here running for cross country?
Just to get closer to that pack of the juniors and to try to lower the times and get us a better placement for the GSC.
Just do the best we can for our team. It's our first year and we have high expectations, so just want to help out the team the best we can and stay up there with them.
While they're just freshmen, Coach Pinkerton does have lofty goals for the Bowens, as along with the rest of the Lady Statesmen cross-country team.
I want them to help us win a championship. I mean, they've got talent. I just got to help them, you know, go down and get more and help them get faster. And I really believe if they'll reach their potential with everybody else, I think we might have a chance.
The Bodens and the Lady Statesmen cross-country team will take the track again this weekend in Mobile, Alabama for the Azalea City Classic. We'll be right back with more Go Statesmen TV.
Welcome back to Go Statesmen TV. We head out now to the Darrell Foreman Classic and catching up with the Delta State golf team as they begin their season-long campaign.
Thanks, Eric. Gina Wilkes here at the Cleveland Country Club for the 2012 Darrell Foreman Classic Invitational, where six other schools are competing with Delta State. I had a chance to meet with Coach Sam Dunning on his thoughts of this season and also with returning golfer Reed Lindsay. Hey, I'm here with Coach Sam Dunning for the Delta State golf team. Coach, thank you so much for being here. Tell me a little bit about this season and what are your expectations?
Well, obviously, this is our first tournament we're starting this morning. The expectations, I've learned not to get them too high, but I've got a lot of new players that look very promising, and I'm looking forward to seeing how they're going to do. We'll play this fall four events, and then we'll play six events this spring, so we'll just see starting today what happens.
Coming off of last season, what are you expecting some of your returners to do this season?
Well, we lost one player. I wish he was still playing, but I expect a lot out of them, some leadership out of them, and we need that with our new boys, and we'll just see what happens with them.
Tell us a little bit about the Classic and how a tradition it is of Delta States, and tell us a little bit about, you know, just starting off the season with that.
Yeah, this is the 24th year we've had the Darrell Foreman Intercollegiate. He was a former coach here before I took over, and we named it after him, and had a lot of tradition here. We've actually won it a few times, actually won it last year by one shot over North Alabama, so it's always a good start to play your home course and see what happens.
Tell us about the teams that are coming. I know that UNA is not here this year, which is different.
They've gone to South Carolina. You know, they're thinking about going Division One, so they've had a chance to go to a bigger tournament. And we've got 11 teams, and we're just a couple of new teams. And hopefully we'll see if they get invited back. If they beat us, they won't.
I'm sure that they wouldn't like that very much. Tell us also, you know, what is it to be a coach, you know, but also working here in the Cleveland community? What are the differences and the highlights and the strengths and weaknesses of you doing both?
Well, there's a lot of hours, but obviously me being the pro here, and we play here every day, that helps because I can control when we play and also control, you know, not getting in the way of the members. And they're very, very, they love having us out here. And that helps a lot because they support us and also help us financially in our, you know, getting our everything. So it works really well. So if it's not broke, don't mess with it. So I'm not.
I'm excited to see, too, that you also brought Grant Goforth back as a player last year, is now one of your GAs, your graduate assistants. What are their roles as graduate assistants and how are they helping you?
Well, it depends on my mood every day, he's doing great, and he's been to all of the tournaments that we'll go to, which will help. He knows how to get there. He knows what's going on. And obviously, I don't get to go to every tournament, so that'll help having him there. Plus, he's a super player, you know, and it'll help him guiding, especially the new players. And I expect a lot out of him and Allie. I feel real comfortable with them going on trips, so we'll just see.
All right, and Coach, and tell us a little bit just about yourself and what does it feel to be a coach now? And you know, how are you out there? Are you going to be playing anytime soon?
No, of course, I've been coaching. I guess this is the 24th year, so I enjoy it. You know, it seems like 24 years was a blur, but we've had a lot of good players come through, and that's what makes it worthwhile when they come back and play in other events at the club. And seeing that they've done good now with families and children now, it just makes you feel good.
Good. Well, thank you so much for being here with us today. Good luck today. Good luck tomorrow. We're excited for all the results.
Well, thank you very much.
We're now joined by Reed Lindsay, golfer for Delta State Statesmen. Yesterday, you ended round one with a 69. Tell us your expectations for going into round two today.
Yesterday, I just didn't really play that good, but I was fortunate to put up a good number. And today, I think we've got to shoot about 15 under as a team to beat Union and win the tournament. So that's going to be a lot better than we did yesterday. Not that we played bad, but we're supposed to do better.
What do you expect for the newcomers? You know, this is their first meet with you guys as a team. So what do you expect of them?
I think they're all solid players. I expect all of them to shoot under par today, I would think. So.
And for your next event, what are you hoping that the team will bring to your next event after opening the season here at home?
I guess time will tell. We've only got two returning starters, so a lot of new faces, and hopefully we can just come together and just get better every tournament and, you know, build on that.
What are you hoping for personally, your personal goals for today? Not only just to shoot under par, but what are you expecting to do out there? I know a couple of holes were giving you trouble yesterday.
Yeah. I want to win, but, you know, I'll either have to play really good or, you know, the leaders won't have to come back to me, but that's my ultimate goal, is to win.
And you led for the Statesmen yesterday, so you're hoping to keep that lead today.
Yeah. I have to go out there and hopefully play better than I did yesterday and give myself a chance to win individually as well as our team winning.
All right. Thank you so much for being
with
us.
No problem.
We'll be right back with more Go Statesmen TV right after this.
Welcome back to the show. We now head out to the Sillars Coliseum to meet the new face of Lady Statesmen basketball, head coach David Midlick.
As you can see right now, Walter Sillars Coliseum, a quiet place, but that certainly won't be the case. It's about a month from now, NCAA basketball practice starts, and Coach David Midlick will have a chance to start his career as the head coach of the Lady Statesmen basketball team.
All right, Coach, talk about the day you got the phone call from Jeremy McClain telling you that you were the man for the job here for head coach of Lady Statesmen basketball.
Well, obviously very exciting, very humbling. We were actually on the way with my wife, Leslie, and youngest son, Will, to a Little League state baseball game. And, just talked a good bit after that game about moving down here, about the opportunity, and just starting really from that night about what I wanted to do from day one and then trying to start getting things done. But humbled to be given the opportunity to lead this program, excited about it, and knew there was a lot of work ahead.
Now, you mentioned being in Greenville, Mississippi, and also your days as a student at Ole Miss. Let's go back first to when you were a student at Ole Miss and a basketball player. What have you taken from that experience into your coaching?
Competitiveness all along, you know, being a high school player and playing at that level at Ole Miss and being around a lot of great players there and also playing against a lot, just the level of intensity and the level of work that you have to put in to be successful on the court.
And now let's go back to your days in Greenville, Mississippi, where for a while you didn't coach basketball. Did you ever have that moment where you were like, okay, here's a moment, now I want to get back into coaching, or I want to go into coaching?
Definitely. You know, when I went to physical therapy school and met my wife, I was not going to coach after playing in college. But after getting the taste of it and coaching at Washington School, I knew that's what I wanted to do and did that on the high school level off and on for 9 years before going up to Austin Peay.
And that experience at Austin Peay, obviously a Division I program, what do you feel like you could carry over from that level down here to mm-hmm. at the Division II level? Is there anything mm-hmm. you think you can carry over, the knowledge that you gained?
Numerous things from all three of the coaches that I worked for. First, Coach Luce, when I was a men's assistant at Austin Peay, the first word that comes to mind with him is integrity. Just ran the program the right way, treated us as a staff the right way, treated the players the right way, firm but fair. He's the all-time winningest coach in High Valley Conference men's history. So just, you know, how to treat people, integrity, and, you know, he he works the same way every day and works hard. He wears two hats, both as the athletic director and the men's basketball coach. From Coach Tracy Wells at Tennessee State, she just really cared about her players. You know, her door was always open. You know, realize that they've got to get to know you as a person as well as a coach. I firmly believe that. And then Carrie Daniels, the last coach I worked for, she kind of had a little bit of both. Really cared and for her players off the court, and I think integrity as well as too. She kind of rolled what Coach Luce and Coach Wells had up in one.
Coach, just want to ask you a couple of more questions. You have your staff in place. You've hired Blessing Chakwa, who played basketball at Mississippi State, so I'm sure she has some familiarity with this area. And also, Veronica Walker, one of the best players in the history of this program, is going to be an assistant for you as well. Talk about how those ladies can help you with the program.
JT, I couldn't be more excited with. You know, I had to hire staff pretty quickly. Met Veronica at the press conference and was just excited. She wanted to continue her studies and get her master's and be a part of this program. I mean, what a face for Lady Statesmen basketball, for the players that are here now that she played with, as well as any recruits, as well as she's thought of on this campus, both as a student and as an athlete. It's a no-brainer for me to say come on, you know, to come on board, and I, you know, love having her. And Blessing as well, didn't know of her. She was recommended to me by a friend, and interviewed. Just I knew right away that she was going to be a great representative for us, was going to have a great relationship with our players, where I felt she could build friendships with them, but still have that line that she would earn and have their respect. In recruiting wise, she knows Mississippi, she knows Louisiana, she knows Texas, and you know what she's done in the first week. She's been here full time as far as recruiting, as far as stuff in the office. She's first class.
Coach, one final question for you. We talked to Brooke a little bit about what you've done in your preseason workouts and drills and things like that. And tell us what you've seen so far with the little bit you've had to work with, and then how excited are you to get started in October?
I think any coach, that's the time that's the best for coaches on the floor. And I think every basketball coach looks forward to October 15th. We've taken it slow on the floor. You know, really want to make sure we do the fundamentals right, broken down the offense from 2-on-2 into, you know, now we're with three players on the floor at the time. I want to make sure they understand the terminology, so that when we start on October 15th, we'll have a basic grasp of our half-court offense and half-court defense. I overheard Brooke say that, you know, the four that played a good bit last year, they've taken on a leadership role. And I believe they're going to have to, with six newcomers on the team. They're going to have to show them exactly what Brooke said, what it means to be a Lady Statesman, the excellence that they're going to strive for and what they're known for. Those four can show it on the floor each day.
What should our fans expect from this basketball team this year?
Effort, enthusiasm, teamwork, each day. I told them, I'm not real big on a lot of slogans, but I want them to be great each day. And the main thing to be great is you be a great teammate, you get better individually, and you get better as, you know, we have 11 on the team. 11 players getting better each day.
Coach, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, JJ.
Webb, joined now by junior guard Brooke Rhodes. And Brooke, you've had about a month now with Coach Midlick here. Tell us, just going through a few drills here and there individually, what have you guys thought of Coach so far?
We're super excited to have him and Coach Blessing as our coaching staff this year. He's expecting greatness just like always. We have a big tradition here at Delta State, and we want to keep it going. And, I mean, we've gone through some drills, and we've had breakdown drills of defense, offense, and, I mean, guard work, post work, and, I mean, we're hoping to be great again this year, too.
We'll be right back after these commercial messages. You're watching Go Statesmen TV.
Welcome back to the show. We now head out to the gridiron to catch up with Jamie Chadwell and the Statesmen football team 2 games into their 2012 season.
I'm Herb Brooks here in the Dorgan Center. The Statesmen are 2 games into the 2012 season, and I had a few minutes to catch up with head coach Jamie Chadwell.
All right, we're here with Statesmen head football coach Jamie Chadwell. Coach Chadwell, 2 weeks into the season, played Fort Valley State here in the season opener. Didn't quite get the result that you were looking for, but, you know, the Statesmen really bounced back on a long road trip to Elizabeth City State. Could you talk a little bit about the first 2 weeks?
Yeah, as you mentioned, you know, we didn't get the start we wanted to. I thought we did some good things through three quarters and then really fell apart in the fourth. And I think it was part of, you know, what they did and some things that we just really didn't execute. And so that week leading up to Elizabeth City wasn't the best week in the world for sure. We had a lot of long faces and a lot of guys maybe really pointing some fingers, you know, and trying to question some things we were doing. But we were able to pull it together in that long road trip. And I think it hit at a great time because we needed to be together as a family. And it worked out well. We had a great win, had some good things happen, and sort of gave us our confidence back and let those guys see that what we're doing could work. And so, obviously, you'd love to be 2-0, but sometimes I think you've got to go through some adversity before you can get really where you want to be. And we did that with week one. Hopefully, we'll learn from it and improve from there.
Absolutely. And, Coach, you know, Elizabeth City, it was a 1,000-mile drive, over 1,000 miles, one way. How do you keep the team's focus for, you know, basically 2 full days on a bus?
Well, you don't, to be honest with you. You tell them, you try not to. When we left Thursday, we just told them, relax. This is just, let's have fun. Let's watch movies. Let's do things. Let's sleep. Same thing Friday, except when we got to where we were staying Friday night. Once we got there Friday night, hey, guys, the pleasure part of the trip, the leisure part of the trip's over. We're here for business. And so, because I don't think there's no way when you're on a bus that long and everything that goes on a bus, there's no way that you can have them or try to get them to be focused the whole time on that. That's not fair to them. It's not fair to really us because your attention span's not going when you're hot and all those things. And so we let them enjoy themselves, let them relax, sort of put their hair down, pull their shirts out, so to speak. And then once we got there Friday night at the hotel, we tried to start being business from that point forward, and it paid off for us.
And it surely did. On the first drive, the Statesmen, you know, come up with a big goal line stand. But before that, you know, you had some, you know, a couple penalties that let them get on the way. But, you know, it was really good to see how the Statesmen stood up, you know, there at the end in the first drive.
It was. You know, we got a great stop the first drive, and we had a block for a punt, and we had it. You know, guy just missed the ball, really, and obviously got a rough in the punter, and it gave them an opportunity to drive down, and we jumped off sides. But our defense bowed up when they needed to. Obviously, it didn't give us the best field position in the world, but we'll take a stop. But we were able to answer offensively and sort of set that tone, and I think that helped us. And then really getting the Hail Mary right there before the end of the game or end of halftime really helped us and gave us some momentum going to the locker room. But we're still making some foolish mistakes that obviously have cost us. I think it really cost us in the first game. It could have cost us in the second game, and that's been a big emphasis this week as far as things that we control those mistakes that way, that really trying to improve those.
Absolutely. And, Coach, as you just mentioned, you have a little time to focus on some things and clean up some things. But you have the University of North Alabama coming in on September the 22nd for pick-picking. What have you seen so far from looking at that team and what the Statesmen need to do to be successful on September 22nd?
Well, you know, it's obviously pick-picking is very important. Playing UNA, which is probably considered our biggest rivalry, it's going to be a huge game for us. Obviously, first conference game, so huge implications there. We've had the opportunity to watch their first couple of games, obviously being an off week, and they're as good as usually are, going to have a lot of talent on both sides of the ball. You know, got some transfers here and there too that from different places. So not as been in depth with them as maybe you would be if obviously you're playing them. We've really tried to hit some things with them, but really focus on some things that we need to improve from week one to week two going into week three, some things that have still not got to where we need them to be successful. So we've been into them a little bit, but our main focus really has just been things that we need to get better at, no matter who we're playing. And so, but we know they're going to be a great team. Probably going to be coming in 2-1, you know, Coach Wallace back in the Gulf South first time. So he's obviously a legend and 3 national championships. He speaks himself. So it's going to be a great challenge for us and just for our young team. A lot of our young guys understand the implications of the rivalry and how intense it is. You know, and for us new coaches, you know, we've been told, but we won't know until we sort of see. So it's a big challenge from there. And so we've been trying not to play it this week. It's next week. And so, but our guys understand that. Our older guys do. And so we've been really trying just to let's fester and let that get ready for next week.
All right, Coach. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks, Coach Chadwell, for taking time to meet with us. And we'll send it back to the studio for more Go Statesmen TV.
That's our show for tonight. We'd like to thank you for joining us and join us each week here on Tuesday as well as on YouTube for another episode of Go Statesmen TV. So don't give up.